Hi everybody, it's Jessica. Welcome back to the Mommy Archives. Today I am doing a video as part of a collab with several members of the YouTube Mommy Meetup. If you're not familiar with the YouTube Mommy Meetup, it's this community created online by Dana from Miss Diaper D, and it's just a place for us to collaborate and come together as moms and talk whatever. And so Di from Being Mommy with Style came up with this idea to do this mommobile cab. And so essentially what we're doing is showing you what's inside our vehicle. And I'm going to do mine just a little bit differently. I'm not going to actually physically be inside my car because Kennedy is napping right now and I don't want to have to walk outside and not be indoors when she's sleeping, and you know, I want to be like in the same building as her is all I'm trying to say. And when she's awake, it's kind of difficult to get out there and film outside. So I figured I'd just bring inside my most important things. And before I show you what those things are, I should mention that this bag that I have was inspired by Jamie from Jalen Mama. A while ago, she did a blowout bag video. And Jamie's a good friend of mine, and my husband actually watches her videos too. And Caleb saw her blowout bag video and he was like, you should have a blowout bag too. And I said, well, I have all those things in my car, they're just not in a bag. He's like, well, that's so much more organized, so you should do it too. So I of course had to let Jamie know that Caleb told me I needed to do this, so I've done it. And now I'm calling it my backup bag. It's full of things that are pretty much to back up several things that I already keep in my diaper bag, as well as a few additional things. After I go through my backup bag, I will also discuss a few of the things that I just keep in my car that I didn't necessarily want to have to bring in to show you. All right, so without further ado, let's take a look at the bag. This is just a wet bag by Itsy Ritzy, and I chose to put everything in a wet bag because I do cloth diaper, and so I thought it'd be nice that if I forgot to bring a wet bag on the go, I would have an additional one to use. So it serves the purpose of holding things, but also if in a pinch I needed a wet bag, I could obviously put the contents in something else and be able to use the wet bag for its purpose for cloth diapers. So let's open her up and see what's inside. I'm just going to unzip it. And at the very top, I keep what I probably reach for the most, and that is some baby wipes. These are the Baby Gannix face, hand, and baby wipes. I like them because they're really thick, they're super gentle, they rate low toxin, and yeah, nice to have some on hand because even though I do cloth diaper, sometimes, you know, it's nice to have some disposable wipes and not necessarily just cloth wipes. So those are in there on the top. Great for quick cleaning up messes real quickly and stuff. I also keep a diaper, a cloth diaper. This is just a Thirsties cover with snaps. And on the inside, I have an Imagine pre-fold and just a Stay Dry liner that I made. So if I forget to pack my diaper bag with cloth diapers, say if I use them all the day before and forgot to restock, or you know, maybe I run out, I have an extra one. I also have just a disposable Baby Gannix diaper. So that's handy if I need it as well. Of course, sometimes when kids have blowouts, they need new outfits, so I just have a little dress for Kennedy because it's summertime right now and it's just one piece that I have to worry about. I don't have to worry about matching outfits or anything, so just a little cotton dress by Carter's. And fortunately, I've never had to change. I've never had that bad of a blowout before, but my dad has been pooped on by Kennedy before with an explosive diaper. It was a disposable that I probably will not be repurchasing, let me just put it that way. Yeah, that wasn't a good experience, but he got it all over him, and after that I decided I should start carrying a shirt on me, and so this is just a random shirt that I don't really care about. My sister-in-law was getting rid of it, and then I took it for the purpose of just using it as a backup, so I wouldn't have to take one of my shirts that I care about as a backup and keep it out of my closet. So just a cotton shirt to keep as a backup for me in case of emergencies. Although I just thought of this, and today I'm wearing a maxi dress, so I'm not sure what I would do if I needed to change like my whole outfit or something and I was wearing like a dress. Maybe I should throw some shorts in there. I don't know, some cheap cotton shorts or something, like athletic shorts. Other things for me are mama cloth, as well as just a disposable sanitary napkin, if you will, and some disposable breast pads. I usually use reusable ones, but just nice to have a backup in case a leak more than I'm anticipating. I also keep this just flannel blanket because, you know, in case I, you know, need a spare nursing cover or something, or it gets cold or windy outside. I mean, it's summer right now, so that's probably not going to happen. But, or if we go to the park and I forgot to bring a blanket to set Kennedy on, Yeah, it's just nice to have an additional little blanket on hand just in case. Also, in a pinch, I can use this to stuff her cloth diaper. So if I, have this and the inside gets dirty or the pre-fold gets dirty, then I can use this in there instead. I had mentioned that, I use a wet bag in case I end up needing the wet bag for diapers or something like that, and I'd have to empty the contents out. So of course, I have just a disposable bag, just a little TK Maxx plastic bag to put the contents in if I need to. Or, if I just have dirty clothes that I just want to, seal up, or dirty diaper, or dirty wipes or something, and I don't have a trash can nearby, I can use that. So just a plastic bag. I have a little just DIY first aid kit, very, very basic. Just the essentials. I'm sure some people keep a very extensive first aid kit in their car, and at some point I will probably go ahead and purchase like a first aid kit just to keep in the car. But for now, I just have a few essentials here, just some basic things. So I have a large absorbent, like gauze pad. I have two small gauze pads, they're just little prepackaged ones. A few different sizes of band-aids, an instant cold compress. Burt's Bees rescue ointment, so you can use this to cut, scrapes, bug bites, whatever. It's just kind of a multi-purpose ointment, so that would come in handy if I needed it. This is just a little medicine keeper by Fossil that I got at Goodwill of all places for like a dollar or two, and I keep Tylenol in there for me. And lastly, my first aid kit. This probably seems really random, but it's a sample of lotion. It's the Nourishing Body Cream in Honey Almond by 100% Pure. And like I said, it may seem random for like an essentials kit, but I have chronically dry hands and I always have to have hand lotion on me. And if I run out, or I, take it out, forget to put it back, or I lose it or whatever, I wanted to have an extra in there. And this doesn't really take up a whole lot of space anyway, so I wasn't too concerned about throwing it in there. Moving on, I have a snack for me. This is a Kind bar. It's the maple pumpkin seed with sea salt. So it's a snack for me. I do not currently have a snack in here for Kennedy because she breastfeeds, so in reality right now, if she wants a snack, that's on the go already. So I'm not too concerned about that, but as she gets older, I'll probably throw a snack in here for her. I have these Colgate Wisps little like to-go toothbrushes because you ever like are out longer than you anticipated and your mouth feels gross. Yeah. These are in there for that purpose. If I feel like I need to brush my teeth, something, quick that I don't have to worry about. And I used to carry them in my purse, but in all reality, I really don't use them that often. And so I tried to like clean out my diaper bag or whatever and get that down to the essentials. So I just decided to keep them in this bag. I have a teether for Kennedy. She's currently teething, and you never know when your kids are gonna start teething again. And when they want something to chew on, they want it right then and there. So I have an extra teether in my bag for Kennedy. Have an umbrella, pretty self-explanatory. You never know when it's gonna start pouring down rain because somehow the weathermen tend to get it wrong. And the last two things are feeding related for Kennedy, a spare bib and a spare spoon, because I have forgotten both of these things before and I've gotten to a restaurant and gone, oh no. So this bib is one that won't be missed because it's supposed to snap, but the snap broke off, but I can still like wrap it around her neck and make it work. So just, I don't want to throw it away because it's still functional, so I just threw it in the backup bag. And then, of course, just I've got plenty of spoons, so I just threw in a spoon to have in case we needed one. All right, guys, so it's empty now. Those are the contents of my backup bag. And as far as other things I keep in the car on a regular basis, I keep my stroller in the trunk. I don't like to like have to pull it in and out if I don't need to, and so I just keep it in my trunk. I always keep a toy in the car for Kennedy. Right now, she just has little crinkly flashcards from Baby Einstein, and it keeps her occupied while we're on the go. I also keep a travel high chair that hooks onto a table. I forget who it's made by, but I got it as part of my online baby shower from Lisa Marie TTC. And that has definitely come in handy because I don't have to worry about all the grimy, sticky ones at the restaurants, or if we're going over to my in-laws, we have a high chair that we can use. So that's definitely come in handy. For me, I always keep sunglasses in the car. I have a pair of prescription sunglasses and a pair of regular sunglasses because my eyes are light green, and so I get really photosensitive when out in the sun driving. So I have to have a pair of sunglasses when I drive. Other than that, there's not too much in my car. I try to keep it pared down. I drive a small sedan. I don't have a ton of room, and so I've gotten a lot better about trying to minimize what I'm keeping in there. But if you think I'm missing anything super essential, please let me know in the comments. Let me know what your car essentials are for your kids in the comments below as well. And I will link all the other ladies that participated down below in the description box, so be sure to check them out. But thank you so much for watching, guys. Please be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you next time. Bye.